Well, so much for seeing the images, okay, but I essentially, if you read the blurb, now computers are enabling us to make all kinds of things, you know, robots and things like this, but the tools are extremely powerful and it's completely transforming how people actually make things. But what I think is important is that as Africans, people actually say, well, we should use these latest technologies to remake our own society, lives, places where we live, tools, products, things we use, and not sort of get wrapped up in some idea that the only solutions that make sense for Africa are extremely low tech. So yeah, I think we want to think about how do we really begin that here at Ashesi, and how can we leverage anything that we may do here to move beyond this campus and help make sure that some of the technology allows people to literally print buildings or cars or new hearts or new lungs or new kidneys can also be used to solve problems here on the continent.
So what we make sense of as design brief is that it's trying to develop, sort of start a community around digital fabrication, we would say, right? A community is made up of individuals. So we're saying if you get a good understanding of an individual and you put them together and into a community, you sort of get a sense of where they cluster, you know, now and where. So if they cluster in the one quadrant, you can, you know that if you move, you need to move them to another quadrant. So you develop the tools and the engagement that will help you move them from one quadrant to the other, right? So on this table, what we're hoping is that the people at the table will identify with some personas, different characters in the community that they want to understand a little more. And then they will take post-it notes and empathize with these personas, right? Of what the people, the personas see, hear, say and do, think and feel. And then they take those post-it notes onto a 2x2 matrix that is not labeled. So it basically will be intuitively placing these notes around and get making sense of them, which will help DK figure out what character, if you will, parameters to play with in building this community.
I'm going to put this one here too. Students are cautious about trying new things. To try out new things. Okay, and then that one is always here. It's funny, since you're or will be overwhelmed, they're cautious, so I also put like, yeah, help. Right? So it's like, part of the reason why they don't want to send is like, they feel like they'll be overwhelmed, and they don't know who can help them.
So concerning the project, as was presented earlier, it was about digital fabrication and how we can get more people to adapt to it, because of the trends, the current changing trends in the world, and how probably everything could be printed digitally rather than building it physically with all the human effort and manpower. So we did a diagonal analysis of it, started with the resistance or the barriers to the adoption, like the adoption of digital fabrication, to what causes less friction. So basically this area is things that encourage it, and this is things that make it more difficult to use digital fabrication as a tool to better our lives. So we had students won't have it because there are no incentives and they have no time to research. And then like what next after school? If you know how to use a 3D printer, you are somewhere like Ghana, what do you do with it? You finish school and then you'll be home, I can do it. And so it's like, who can help you? If you don't have any knowledge of it, who can help you? And then, you know, students are always exhausted, they care about their GPA. So like there's literally nothing pushing you to go and use the 3D printer or learn how to use it. So over here too, we noticed that students actually like learning a lot. And then Ashesi students, for example, are technologically inclined. And then they also prefer doing work with their hands rather than theories, which is encouraged by this kind of stuff. And then students like to try out new things too. So while we're analyzing it, we noticed that like the positives or the things that can drive digital fabrication in our universities are actually less than the things that cause resistances. So we decided to figure out ways that we can help empower university students to, you know, adapt to it more and then use it. So we saw that if we are to create businesses around this for post-graduation involvement, it could actually help, because when you are done with school and you can actually go into a company where they use this to make tools and you know, stuff that can be paid for, you can make money. And then we also thought if you include it in the curriculum, people won't have an option but to study. And through that, maybe you get people who actually like it and have, you know, some kind of motivation given to them. And we also thought about educated coaches who help the people who want to learn, because some people want to learn about it, but the printers are just there all the time and you can't do anything about it. You don't even know how to use SketchUp to design the models and all that. And also competitions, create a study hall, and then also hyper-relevance. Hyper-relevance meaning that all the things that we'll be using digital fabrication for should be so relevant that people won't have an option, but they'll be inclined to care about what's happening. Like what happened the last competition, the 3D printing stuff, that someone went to do a tool to help you plug in your appliance if you don't have like the 3-pin wall socket adapter. So you see, these kind of small things are able to transform life. So if you use these printers or these digital fabrication tools to do kind those kind of things, you see that it will help people become inclined in using all of these. So that's what we came up with.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much.